Finally, you're listening to the Hour of the Time. I'm William Cooper. I have no idea what went wrong. I was on satellite, and then all of a sudden, I was not on satellite. So, you tell me, folks, what all that means, because I really don't know. And I haven't got time to dwell on it, because I've got a program to do for you tonight. A lot of neat things coming your way. For instance, we're planning a trip to Rachel, Nevada, where over a three-day weekend, and you can guess which one that's going to be, you'll be able to sit out in the desert with me and see what you can see. Maybe you'll see something, maybe you won't, but you'll get my full 100% attention. You'll have my standard UFO 101 lecture and slideshow, so if you've already seen it, don't bother coming. It's going to be $150 per person, ladies and gentlemen, meals and lodging provided, but we can only take 17 people total. And if you're husband and wife and you don't get your tickets in first, if you don't get your payments in first, ladies and gentlemen, and you're husband and wife, you may have to split up because the double beds or the queen-size beds in the rooms by themselves are first come, first serve. If you don't want room or lodging and you want to bring a tent and a sleeping bag and camp out in the desert, then give me a call and we can negotiate what your fee will be, but it will be less in any case. Don't go away. I'll be right back with a whole bunch of other very interesting things to tell you.
Hello, baby. Yeah, this is the Big Bopper speaker. Oh, you sweet thing. Do I want? Will I want? Oh, baby, you know what I like. Chantilly lace and a pretty face and a pony tail hanging down with a little walk and a giggle and a thought. Make the world go round. Ain't nothing in the world like a big-eyed girl that make me act so funny, make me spend my money, make me feel real loose like a long-necked goose, like a girl.
Oh, baby, that's the one I like.
What's that, baby? But, oh, honey. But, oh, baby, you know what I like. Chantilly lace had a pretty face, had a pony tail hanging down, a wiggle in the walk and a giggle in the talk. Lord, make the world go round, round, round. There ain't nothing in the world like a big-eyed girl that makes me act so funny, makes me spend my money, makes me feel real loose like a long-necked goose, like a girl. Oh, baby, that's the one I like. What's that, honey? Pick you up at 8 and don't be late. But baby, I ain't got no money, honey.
Boy, that sounds like us around here. I ain't got no money, honey. Especially after that baby was born. Babies cost a lot of money. An awful lot. Also, folks, I have to tell you that once you have submitted your fee for the trip to Rachel, Nevada, it is non-refundable. We can't do these things If people send in their money and then change their mind, then we've already closed it out and nobody else buys that place, it can't be done. So, remember, think about it before you send your money in. Once it's sent in, it's non-refundable. You will be responsible. Okay? And if you can't go and you've already sent your money in, that means you have to sell your place to somebody else or kiss your sweet money goodbye. That's the way it goes. Don't say we didn't warn you. Don't say we didn't tell you, because you just heard it. And if you call about it, we'll tell you that too. By the way, folks, if you have not seen my presentation on UFOs, you ain't seen nothing, ever. Not only UFOs, but the moon and Mars and a whole bunch of other stuff. It's incredible. It takes about 6 hours to get through. And your eyes will be opened and you will see the light. Yes, sir, you will see the light. Also, in my book, I wrote that the Knights Templars claimed that they were in possession of the Holy Grail and many other of the relics, the religious relics of Christianity. This is from Reuters, Dateline Rome. The plot surrounding the age-old quest for the Holy Grail thickened Thursday when members of a mysterious religious order claimed the relic used to collect the blood of Christ was in their hands. The Order of the Knights Templar, who claimed descent from the order founded in 1120 in Jerusalem by French crusaders, presented what it said was the Holy Grail during a news conference at its headquarters in an apartment in Rome. Quote, "We have decided it is time that the world knew about the Grail's true whereabouts," said Rocco Zingardo di San Ferdinando, Grand Master of the Templars in Italy, reverently holding up a minute green mottled glass flask. End quote. So, ladies and gentlemen, another thing that I said in my book has come true. You see, they had not made the public announcement when I wrote my book, but my research had told me that that's what they believed. They believed that they have it in their possession. Is it the true Holy Grail? How the hell should I know, folks? I'm just one poor, lonely, helpless, scared individual with a family to feed. I really don't know much about anything. We also have something else to offer you, and we offer this on the condition that you will use it legally and lawfully and will obey the law, whatever the law happens to be. Now remember, when you use something like this, you do have to obey the law. You can't transmit over state lines, cross bodies of waters into foreign countries, stuff like that. But we have now figured how to get the Hour of the Time and any other broadcast that you want to get on the air in your area. We have located the best FM broadcast transmitter, and it's not a surveillance bug. It tunes very easy to any frequency you want to broadcast on. Runs on 12 to 15 volts DC. You can use it at home or in your car. It can be connected to a mixer, a CD, a tape player, a microphone, stereo, or radio, whatever you need to broadcast with. It transmits monaural, not stereo, but at some later date we hope to be able to provide a stereo FM transmitter. Because all of our tapes, if you order tapes from us, they're stereo, folks. Beautiful. Studio quality tapes. Now, most FM transmitters are 1/10 of a watt, 5 to 100 milliwatts of power. The range is about 300 feet, you know, and that's on a good night. These that we are offering have 3 watts of output power, gives this transmitter a true range of many miles. Many miles, folks. In fact, ours gives you 60 times more get heard power. Also, the power it takes to drive most RF amplifiers from 10 to 100 watts If one day you want to be heard in the next town, we use the very best parts and PC boards in our transmitters, a one-half wave dipole antenna, and plans for a three-quarter wave antenna are included with each order. You can either order a kit or you can order it completely assembled. You have to buy the power supply, which you can obtain at any Radio Shack. Comes with complete instructions and everything else. I don't have prices tonight, but I'll get those prices to you either tomorrow night or Monday. This is a great thing, folks. It really is. And remember, we're selling these to you only on the condition that you use them legally and lawfully according to whatever the law is in your area and whatever the Big Brother thinks his law is, or wants to make you think his law is more like it. So, be thinking about that. If you'd like to be a broadcaster of the Hour of the Time in your local area and other shows, if you'd like to have your own radio show, we're going to give you the means to do that, ladies and gentlemen. And I think you're going to love it. I think you're just going to be absolutely bowled over with it. It's going to be a lot of fun. Remember, we're taking a trip to Rachel, Nevada. I can't give you a date yet, but I will probably tomorrow or Monday. It's going to be $150 per person, and you're going to have probably a day of lectures and slides, and then you're going to have a guided tour of the area conducted by me. Then we're going to sit out all night long for a couple of nights, and you'll be able to sleep in the daytime, and see if you can see what so many thousands of people have seen standing out there in the desert near the infamous Area 51. And it's always fun. It's always been fun for me. Sometimes I've seen things and filmed them and videotaped them, and other times I spent weeks out there and didn't see anything, but it was always a lot of fun. Also, after much searching in bookstores and checking distributors, who will only tell you the book is unavailable, The Ominous Parallels is available in the United States direct from the publisher, Penguin Books, for $10 plus $2 postage and handling. It's yours. So you got to write Penguin Books, send them $12 postpaid. The address is Penguin, USA, P.O. Box 999, Department 17109. Bergenfield, New Jersey. Bergenfield is spelled B as in box, B-E-R-G-E-N-F-I-E-L-D. Bergenfield, New Jersey, 07621. That's the Ominous Parallels. By the way, this was dug out by our Pennsylvania station chief. The Ominous Parallels, $12 postpaid. Send it to Penguin, USA, Post Office Box 999, Department 17109, Bergenfield, New Jersey, 07621. He says, an old-timer and a major bookseller told me that they were suddenly and mysteriously bought up years ago. At the time, he thought it was the U.S. government or some front organization controlled by them, and this guy isn't even in the Patriot or Freedom Movement. It was he who penetrated the unavailable veil and gave me the publisher direct. I recommend this for every American and Canadian. Of course, you've heard me quote from it many times on the Hour of the Time, and I think we did two or three segments just on the Ominous Parallels. So you know what I think about it. I highly recommend that you read it if you want to understand what's going on in this country today. Of course, if you don't understand, don't read it. You know, it's up to you. Amsterdam. An unsuspecting American airline passenger was detained after a Dutch customs agent put explosives in his suitcase to test airport security. Can you imagine this, folks? An American citizen was detained in the Netherlands after a Dutch customs agent put real explosives, not a fake explosives to have a test of the air support security, but real explosives in his suitcase to test airport security. But guess what? He forgot to remove them before the plane departed for Florida, or at least that's what they say. And the justice ministry, of course, in Amsterdam is very embarrassed. That's what they say. What if it was supposed to blow up in flight, but something went wrong and it didn't? It didn't blow up. Why would they hold a drill using real explosives in a passenger's baggage? The passenger doesn't even know it's in there. And then forget to take it out before the plane departs. Passenger Paul Holloway, a professor at the University of Florida, was detained when a Northwest Airlines flight from Amsterdam's Schiphol Airport landed Friday and two devices containing explosives were discovered in his luggage in Orlando. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, I don't believe this bullshit for one second. They put that in his bag to blow up that plane, and something went wrong. I can't prove that, but you tell me any other reason why a Dutch customs agent would put real explosives in an unsuspecting passenger's suitcase and let the plane take off. Remember what I told you about exponentially increasing terrorist incidents? And remember I also told you it ain't terrorists. Actually, they are, but not the kind you've been taught to believe. And listen to this from the Department of Defense. The complete file is available for download as DD55255.zip. And I don't know where. I don't know where you can get this. It's somewhere. But the reference is Department of Defense, publication 4515.13-R, reference H. DOD cooperation with civilian law enforcement officials. Under guidance established by the secretaries of the military departments and the directors of the defense agencies concerned, the planning and execution of compatible military training and operations may take into account the needs of civilian law enforcement officials for information when the collection of the information is an incidental aspect of training performed for a military purpose. In this regard, the needs of civilian law enforcement officials may be considered when scheduling routine training missions. This does not permit the planning of creation of missions or training for the primary purpose of aiding civilian law enforcement officials, and it does not permit conducting training or missions for the purpose of routinely collecting information about U.S. citizens. Oh, no. It just says that if law enforcement needs this information, you can consider this when scheduling routine training missions. This is nothing but government double talk, which says posse comitatus is out the window. Out the window. Local law enforcement agents may accompany routinely scheduled training flights as observers for the purpose of collecting law enforcement information. This provision does not authorize the use of DOD aircraft to provide point-to-point transportation and training flights for civilian law enforcement officials. Such assistance may be provided only in accordance with DOD 4515.13-R, reference H. And this comes from ADA 272130. DODD 5525.5, and it's entitled DOD Cooperation with Civilian Law Enforcement Officials. If you're interested in looking it up, I know most of you never look anything up, just wait around for somebody to tell you something that sounds okay, so you go with it. Too bad. Too bad. You're going to get what you deserve, puppets. Go watch Pinocchio, bozo. Yeah, I'm talking to you. Couch potato right over there in the corner. You with the Budweiser in your hand. You don't think I know? I can look right through this microphone. I'm looking right at you. Yep, you're wearing a big old t-shirt, blue jeans, and you got a Budweiser in your hand. S-974. S-974. Oh, this is a good one. Listen to this, folks. they're getting crazier than ever. Anti-Electronic Racketeering Act of 1995. Wait till you hear this. The Anti-Electronic Racketeering Act of 1990. If this passes, you might as well throw your computer and your telephones in the trash because you'll be a racketeer if you use them. S-974. S means Senate bill. Senate 974. Has many effects not good on law enforcement's use of intercepted communications. It would also make it unlawful for any person to publicly disseminate encoding or encrypting software, including software currently allowed to be exported unless it contained a universal decoding device. This more than likely means that Clipper-style key escrow systems could be disseminated, but not strong private cryptography. The Senate sponsors are Grassley, Republican, of IA, whatever that is. I'm not into this zip, this state abbreviation stuff, so I don't know what IA is. Probably Indiana. I don't know. Idaho. I really don't know. Grassley, Republican, IA. That's the state. Senate status, currently not active and probably won't move before the August recess. Senate citizen action required. Request bill. Oh, get the bill. Familiarize yourself with it and then call and write everybody if you think that'll do any good and tell them not to pass it. Personally, I don't think they really care what we think anymore. I really don't. And now, some very, very interesting information on Governor Frank Keating of Oklahoma. Check this out, folks. Tell me this guy wasn't on a fast track. And I mean fast track. And things are going to be very clear to you in just a few moments. A lot of the pieces of the puzzle are going to fall into place. And where else could you get it? Nowhere else but the Hour of the Time. And this was ferreted out by our Oklahoma station chief. Francis Anthony Keating II, 25th governor of Oklahoma. In 1994, Frank Keating won the Republican nomination for governor and was elected to the office in a three-way race, winning by a margin of 17 percentage points. He was born February the 10th, 1944, in St. Louis, Missouri. Before he was 6 months old, his family moved to Tulsa, Oklahoma. He is the son of Anthony Francis Keating II and Ann Keating, both deceased. Raised as a strict Roman Catholic, Keating was graduated from Cassia Hall High School, pronounced Cassia, an all-male private Catholic school. In 1962, while at Cassia Hall, Keating was the president of the student council. He received a Bachelor of Arts in History from Georgetown University in 1966, where he was the president of the yard, which is the equivalent of student body president. Remember, Georgetown is Jesuit. And was 2 years ahead of Bill Clinton while it rolled at Georgetown, and probably knew Clinton's famous professor, and may have even been Keating's mentor also. Keating earned a doctor of law from the University of Oklahoma College of Law in 1969 and was the president of his class at law school. He is presently a member of the Oklahoma Bar Association. Keating's public service career began as an FBI agent. Now listen to this, folks. Began as an FBI agent where he investigated new left terrorist activities, bombings, and bank robberies on the West Coast. He then returned to Tulsa to work as an assistant district attorney. From 1972 to 1974, Keating served in the Oklahoma House of Representatives. From 1974 to 1981, he served in the Oklahoma Senate and was unanimously elected Republican leader of the Oklahoma Senate. From 1981 to 1986, Keating was the United States Attorney for the Northern District of Oklahoma and was the national chair of the United States Attorneys. In 1986, he was asked by President Reagan and subsequently by President Bush to serve as the highest-ranking Oklahoman in both administrations. During his stay in Washington, Keating supervised more than 100,000 employees while he served in three important posts. First, listen carefully. As the Assistant Secretary of the United States Treasury from 1986 to 1988, where he directed the United States Customs Service, the Secret Service, and the, guess what, Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. Then as the Associate Attorney General from 1988 to 1989, where he presided over the United States prison system, the United States Marshals, the Immigration and Naturalization Service, and all 94 U.S. attorneys, and third, as Acting Deputy Secretary and General Counsel of Housing and Urban Development, 1991 through 1993, under Secretary Jack Kemp. In 1988, Keating, a devout Roman Catholic, catch this, Knights of Malta all the way, was named the Knight Commander of the Holy Sepulchre by Pope John Paul II. Civic activities, I could go on and on and on and on and on. How about that, ladies and gentlemen? Isn't this interesting? Isn't this absolutely mind-boggling? You see, I tried to warn you a long time ago, but you guys just, you know, must be one of those conspiracy wackos. What do I know? I don't know nothing. I don't know nothing, guys. I'm just a conspiracy wacko. You know? You know about those guys. You want to stay away from them. Also, Buchanan. Pat Buchanan. Knights of Malta, all the way, has a diplomatic passport. The Knights of Malta is a recognized sovereign nation. He has sworn allegiance on blood oaths to the Knights of Malta and to the Pope. In fact, when the Pope is in danger, it is the Knights of Malta who take the place of the Swiss mercenary guards in the Vatican to guard the Pope. You want this guy as your president? Go ahead, man. He's recommended by Tom Valentine. And listen to this. This is from the Mojave Valley Daily News. August the 20th, 1995. Prescott, Arizona. Associated Press, a man and woman driving at speeds more than 100 mile per hour. Now listen to this, because it's important that you listen to what they supposedly did and then how they were found at the end. A man and woman driving at speeds more than 100 miles per hour fired out the window of their car as they led highway patrolmen on an hour-long chase through northern Arizona Saturday morning that spanned more than 100 miles and ultimately ended in the couple's death. Remember, they're driving 100 miles an hour. Both of them are firing out the windows. The chase started in Peach Springs on United States 66 after Arizona Department of Public Safety officers tried to stop the man for driving 55 in a 45-mile-per-hour zone, said DPS officer spokesman Sergeant Dave Myers. About 30 minutes into the chase, Havapai County Sheriff's deputies set up two vehicles on either side of Interstate 40 near Ash Fork. The deputies fired several shots as the car raced through. A mile down the road, sheriff's deputies set up a roadblock on Route 89, 4 miles north of Prescott. As the driver approached, he slowed, made a U-turn, and headed onto a dirt county road. The chase ended when the two turned off the road to a dirt field where they struck a pile of irrigation pipes. Now listen carefully. When police found them, they were handcuffed and each had a shot to their head. They were dead. Officers have not identified the couple and have no motive, Myers said. Don't ask me what the answer is, ladies and gentlemen. I don't even know what the question is. Don't go away. I might be back. Thank you. Back some memories right along with the silver dollars. They bring back memories. And you know, I remember when I was a little kid, one of my grandmothers or grandfathers or great grandmothers or grandfathers, I don't remember who it was, showed me a small gold coin once. I think it was a $10 gold piece. But I remember silver dollars very, very well. I also remember silver dimes and silver quarters. I remember those very well. And they bring back lots of memories. I remember one time when I was a kid, my parents went to Las Vegas and brought back tons of silver dollars. We played with them. I don't know if they won or they just cashed in a whole bunch of money and bought silver dollars to make us think they won. I really don't know. And I really don't care. They had fun. That's all that matters. What happened to our money? How many of you are aware, and I know that all of you who read Veritas are certainly aware, that we don't have any money? What you're using every day is not money. Even the coins you're using are not money. The Constitution specifically says, no state shall tender in payment of debts anything other than gold or silver coin. It specifically says gold and silver, and it specifically says coin, and it says no state shall tender anything in payment of debts other than gold and silver coin. It doesn't say gold or silver coin. It says gold and silver coin. Now, that's the best example I can give you and throw it right in your face that the Constitution, in fact, is not in effect. Was thrown in the trash can a long time ago. The other way I can give you this 10th Amendment resolution. It's a bunch of crap, folks. You see, the Constitution has a 10th Amendment. It's the supreme law of the land. If the Constitution was in effect, why would you be going around trying to pass 10th Amendment resolutions? And if the Constitution's not in effect, doesn't that tell you that you can pass all the resolutions you want? Resolutions don't have any force in law. And if the supreme law of the land doesn't have any force, and if you can't get a state's attorney general to bring a case before the Supreme Court suing the federal government to enforce the real 10th Amendment, then your puny little 10th Amendment resolutions are just spitting in the wind. It's really masturbation. It feels real good, but it's non-productive. The same with Federal Reserve notes and your copper-clad coins. They're worthless. You can take those coins down to a junk dealer and ask him what the real value of the metal in those coins are, and you're going to get a rude awakening. You see, they put that little fine coating of silver alloy. It's not real silver either, folks. You think it is. A little bitty silver in there. Most of it is nickel, I believe. And that's to fool you into thinking that you really have silver coins. You see, if you don't use real money to buy something, you're trading with instruments of debt. And if you're trading with instruments of debt, which is unlawful money, you haven't bought anything. You have just sort of rented it. That's why you have a certificate of title instead of a patent title. Or an allodial title. That's why you have warrant deeds on your house instead of allodial patent titles. Go look up the definition of deed in Black's Law Dictionary, and you're going to choke on that one. You're going to choke. It's going to blow your mind. I'm not going to tell you what it is, you see, because part of my mission is to get you up off your lazy butts to do it yourself. You don't like to hear me talk like that, folks. But there was a time when I just thought Americans were so wonderful and so brilliant, and all it needed was somebody just to get them going in the right direction and everything was going to be okay. And I was just dripping with niceness to everybody. You know what? Everybody loved me, but nothing happened.
when I started throwing it in your face, and when I let you know what a sheeple really was and who the sheeple really were, things started happening. People started waking up. They started looking in the mirror. People set out to prove me wrong and prove me right and became allies on our side, and now they're fighting alongside with us. So I really, frankly, don't care if you like it or not. It gets the job done, and that's my purpose. Now, I'm going to tell you something else. Look around right now to those people sitting in the room with you. They're either your friends or your loved ones, and you have an obligation to them. Especially if they've been with you for a long time, or if you have children who are dependent upon you doing the responsible and right thing. If you can't look them in the eye right now and tell them that you have assured that at least a portion of your assets are protected by real money, then you must make this call. If you don't, very simply, and I'm going to say it right in front of you and right in front of them, you don't love them at all. And that's the truth. Call 1-800-289-2646. That's 1-800-289-2646. Tell them you're a listener to the Hour of the Time. Tell them you'd like to get your hands on some real money. Tell them what you can afford, whether it's to buy a little bit over a few months' time or a whole bunch at once or just one or two coins a month or every 2 months. They'll work with you and they'll help you. Do it now. 1-800-289-2646. And don't put it off, because if you do, you and I both know, and everybody sitting in that room with you knows, that you won't do it at all.
You know, I'm almost grown. Yeah, and I'm doing all right in school. They ain't said I broke no rules. I ain't never been in dust. I don't browse around too much. Don't bother me, leave me alone. Anyway, I'm almost grown. I don't run around with no mom. Got myself a little job. Buy me a little car. Drive my girl in the park. Don't bother to see the phone. Anyway, we almost grown.
Yes, boy, the messengers are flying all over the internet, and there's articles in Spotlight, all how the military, the United States government, is planning upon rounding up militia leaders. Folks, how many times I got to tell you, if you wrote my book 5 years ago, if you read my book 5 years ago, you would have known it 5 years ago. And everybody's acting like this is news. It ain't news. Uh-uh. No, sir. I've been telling you for years. I wrote in my book also that patriots would be considered to be suffering from a psychotic mental illness. Did you know right now that patriots and gun owners who have committed no crimes are being arrested and taken to mental institutions for competency testing? And some of them aren't coming out of those places, and they have never broken a law or done anything wrong. They just express a loyalty to the Constitution, or they own weapons. Legal weapons. Don't believe it? Well, one of these nights I'll do a show on it. I'll just open your eyes and ears like crazy. And eventually, ladies and gentlemen, not just militia leaders, listen to me carefully, not just militia leaders, but all patriot leaders will be arrested if you allow it to happen. The rest of you will be left leaderless and will run around in circles like chickens with your heads cut off, because that's what people do without leaders. And the New World Order will become a fact. Now, you don't think there's a new world order? Oh, boy. Listen to this. They just continue to prove me right. United States Atlantic Command press release, Norfolk, Virginia. for immediate release. Release CN95-10, August the 8th, 1995. Opening ceremony begins NATO exercise by Sergeant First Class Ramona Reznicek, 22nd Mobile Public Affairs Detachment, Fort Bragg, North Carolina. That's Bobo Gritz's old stomping grounds. Of course, he don't have anything to do with any of this. Nope. Innocent. Fort Polk, Louisiana. Secretary of Defense William Perry greeted troops from NATO partners and former Eastern Bloc nations at NATO's Partnership for Peace Program opening ceremony Tuesday at the Joint Readiness Training Center at Fort Polk. You see, folks, all the Eastern Bloc Warsaw Pact nations are performing maneuvers with United States military forces to function as the United Nations peacekeeping force, just like I've always been telling you. The opening ceremony marked the beginning of Cooperative Nugget 95, the first partnership for peace exercise to be conducted in the United States. About 1,100 soldiers from two NATO countries and 14 Central and Eastern European countries will practice and develop their combined peacekeeping skills along U.S. soldiers through August the 26th. Troops from Canada, the United Kingdom, and the United States, all NATO members and the Partnership for Peace countries, which are Warsaw Pact members, march onto Fort Polk's honor field. The Partnership for Peace nations include Albania, Bulgaria, the Czech Republic, Estonia, Hungary, Kyrgyzstan, Latvia, Lithuania, Poland, Romania, Slovak Republic, Slovenia, the Ukraine, and Uzbekistan. Now listen to this. General John Sheehan, Supreme Allied Commander and Commander-in-Chief of NATO's United States Atlantic Command, praised the upcoming exercise. Listen carefully, folks. He tells you the truth. Quote, "It is through exercises such as this that truly we can create a new world order in which the militaries of the world can work in coordination and cooperation to fill a better peace," end quote. Now, all of you who wrote me those letters telling me that I am full of it, up to my ears, sit down and write me another one and apologize. I don't think you have the guts. Perry began by introducing all of the countries on the parade field and welcoming everyone attending. Quote, "On these grounds, where 50 years ago our forces trained for war in Europe, we now train our forces for new missions of peace," end quote. In 1941, more than 400,000 soldiers participated in the Louisiana maneuver on Fort Polk, where they tested equipment before fighting on European battlefields. Quote, "This Louisiana maneuver is a tremendous opportunity to learn more about one another, from one another, and how to conduct military operations with one another. I urge everyone to seize this opportunity," end quote. And quote, 50 years ago, in a report to the Congress, the Chief of Staff of the Army, George Marshall, said, "If man does find the solution to world peace, it will be the most revolutionary reversal of his record we have ever known. We might not find the solution on these fields to world peace, but by developing understanding, cooperation, and trust, we can secure a peace among our nations," end quote, said Perry. Field Marshal Sir Richard Vincent, Chairman of the NATO Military Committee, was one of the dignitaries. Quote, "It gives me great pleasure to open Exercise Cooperative Nugget, which is the second of the 10 Partnership for Peace exercises planned for this year, and importantly, the first ever conducted in the United States," end quote, said Vincent. Quote, "You don't need me to remind you that these are the kind of practical and highly relevant skills which servicemen and women for many of the nations represented on parade today are needing to develop for everyday use in environments from Cyprus to Haiti, Rwanda, the former Yugoslavia, and sadly many other places as well," end quote. Vincent encouraged those participating to share their experiences with fellow exercise participants to become more effective should they be called as individual nations or collectively to undertake similar tasks in the future. What are they practicing, ladies and gentlemen? Well, I've been watching it on KU band on satellite, and I've been perusing every word of every press release. They are practicing control of civilians. They are practicing rooting out and eliminating patriot leaders and militia organizations. They are practicing finding hidden firearms. They are practicing disarming civilian populations. They are practicing searching civilian vehicles for contraband. And they are practicing controlling large number of civilian personnel and transportation of those civilian air personnel to concentration camp. Don't believe it? You start looking into it yourself. It's all over the internet. Now, here's something else for all you deadheads, of which Bill Clinton is one. A British publication called Freedom published an interesting note a few weeks before the death of Jerry Garcia of the Grateful Dead. It claims that 1968 Federal Bureau of Investigation memorandum obtained through an FOIA lawsuit justifies the employment of Grateful Dead lead singer Jerome Garcia to channel youth dissent and rebellion into more benign and non-threatening directions. How about that? Don't forget, folks, for the Rachel, Nevada, Area 51 Groom Dry Lake trip, we can only take 17 people. Anybody who goes above that number will have to camp out with a tent or sleeping bag or whatever in the desert. Probably won't need a tent, but you would need a sleeping bag. Now, the RAND Corporation has done a study. It's the National Institute of Justice update called State and Local Responses to Terrorism. State and Local Responses to Terrorism. You can get copies of the complete report from the RAND Corporation. The RAND Corporation, spelled R-A-N-D. And it costs $13 plus shipping and handling charges. I don't know what those charges are. But you can get it. Let me see. It's called the Domestic Terrorism, a National Assessment of State and Local Law Enforcement Preparedness. So write this down. Domestic Terrorism, a National Assessment of State and Local Law Enforcement Preparedness. It's $13. I don't know what the shipping and handling charges are. But you can find those out, as well as the address of where to send it, by calling area code 310-451-7002. That's area code 310-451-7002. I suggest that you do that. Here's a letter from Lee. I want to read this because I like it. Says, Bill, your show Friday night brought it all down to basics. It is one thing to talk about fighting for our freedom and arguing the fine points of constitutional law. It is fine to train with the militia and prepare for the worst. Unfortunately, we tend to lose track of what is really important while doing the obvious things. There is, however, nothing that brings reality into focus like the miracle of a newborn baby. Anyone who can hold a baby and not understand what it is all about isn't worth having on our side. Allison Dovey provided that centering force for many of us tonight. It has been 20 years since my daughter was born, but tonight you brought it all back. Thank you. I know this can work because I have been working on a friend for over a year. A week ago Thursday, he and his wife had a baby boy. He wasn't planned, for the father is 50 and the mother 37. But some things just happen without planning. On Sunday, he brought them home and moved into the newly constructed nursery. Monday, he called and asked if I still had a spare shortwave and could he borrow it, and did I have a list of programs to listen to, and how does he program his VCR to record them anyhow? All my effort over the last year appealing to his reason did nothing. A little 6-pound, 5-ounce bundle has turned him around and set his priorities on track. Signed, Lee. I want to thank you, Lee. This made my day, and I think maybe it might make some other people's day out there to know that we have one more on our side. And remember, I've always told you folks, if just one broadcast just brings one more to our side, then I've done my job. Well, all this stuff about Linda Thompson faking her tape Waco the Big Lie is just that. I think I'm the only one who ever stuck with her, besides some of you out there. But I'm talking about in the media, in this so-called Patriot Leadership Group. Everybody else bailed out and swore that she faked Waco the Big Lie. Well, this is going to tell the truth, folks. You see, I put Waco the Big Lie on a computer and examined every frame of it. Nothing was faked. Not one single frame in that videotape was fake at all. I did put the tape on computer that was made by Mike McNulty and found a lot of digitized, faked, phonied, and altered frames on that tape. Now, Linda has issued a challenge, and I'm telling you right now, these jerks won't take her up on it because they're all liars. Linda says she'll take a lie detector test about Waco the Big Lie. How about Tom Valentine and Mike McNulty and James Pate and Reed Irvine and Ron Engelman and Bobo Gritz and all of these people who say that they know that she faked that film, that they know that the film is not real? Linda will take a lie detector test. Now, if the rest of them won't, we'll all know, won't we? The Justice Department, folks, this is dated August 17th, 1995. That's the date that Allison was born. The Justice Department asked Senator Arlen Specter to delay the planned hearing into the deadly 1992 standoff with Randy Weaver at Ruby Ridge, Idaho, because it would jeopardize its own investigations. What investigations? Probably investigations in how to cover it up deeper and deeper and deeper. I don't know what the answer is going to be. But if they'd asked me, I know what my answer would have been. What else do we have here? Oh, this is a good one, folks. Listen carefully. They now have the American Institute of Physics Bulletin of Physics News, number 236, August 7th, 1995, by Philip F. Hsu and Ben Stein. Remember, they've had this for a long time, but they're just now telling the public. A silicon device for triggering electrical activity in a nerve cell has been constructed, opening possibilities for two-way non-toxic communication between computer chips and nerve cells. And folks, if you don't know what that means, then you're playing on the wrong team. You need a brain transplant yourself and maybe one of these silicon devices so that we can trigger some electrical activity in your nerve cells. How about that? How about that, folks? It's true. Now, listen very carefully. Mind control is a reality. Tomorrow night, I'm going to read you the text from a treaty which confirms. You see, we never could confirm it. We knew that they were experimenting in weather control back in the 50s. We knew that they had made some progress. At some point, a curtain came down and all the literature stopped being published. You couldn't find anything on weather control, and everything that you could find was classified and they wouldn't let you look at it. So there was no confirmation on whether they had weather control, whether they could use it, or how extensive it had been developed. We have located a treaty between the United States and Canada, which confirms that weather control exists and the United States and Canada mutually agree not to use weather control against each other. Don't miss tomorrow night. I'm going to read it to you verbatim from the treaty. Good night, folks. God bless each and every one of you. Almost forgot, tape. We have almost ready the tapes of the Oklahoma Station Chief's 12-hour lecture at the last Intelligence Service CAGI convention that was held in St. John's, Arizona. If you'd like to order an advance copy, it's $70 for all 12 hours postpaid. Make checks or money orders out to Annie, A-N-N-I-E, and that goes for everything that you ever order from us except Veritas, which should be made out to Veritas. Make checks or money orders out to Annie, A-N-N-I-E. Send them to the address that you will hear at the end of this broadcast. 12 hours of the most compelling lecture that you'll ever hear on how to conduct an investigation. It's not so much about the findings, but how. It was a training lecture for our operatives, folks. You will, through this, learn how professional the intelligence service and the Citizens Agency for Joint Intelligence really are. You will be amazed.
For you, my friend.